Hello, kumusta po mga kamatinig? Welcome to our new episode. This is Quarter 4, Week Number 4. And today's episode, we will be having reading and measuring temperature using thermometer. But before that, I will present first the answer key from the previous episode natin, Fourth Quarter, Week Number 3. Please check now your answers. Here is the answer key for Mathray nga, Quarter 4, Week Number 3. Number 1, the answer is 120 cubic centimeters. Number 2, the answer is 343 cubic decimeters. And number 3, 720,000 liters. Wala pong cube ang liters, ha? Kaya ang daming nagkamali dun sa ating comment section. Kaya, take note of that. Alright, congratulations again to those who got a perfect score. Kaya naman, abangan natin mamaya kung sino ang ating top 5 na sobrang bibilis na sumagot at nakakuha din ng perfect score. At sila ang ating Mathnics of the Week. Kaya, kung gusto nyo ring maging Mathnic of the Week, dapat bilisan ng konti ang pagsagot ng ating Math Try nga! Pero dapat, syempre, kailangan tumuto ka muna. Kailangan manood, makinig nat matuto kay Maestro Olaso. Kaya, oops, don't forget to subscribe yung ating YouTube channel and hit yung ating notification bell para lagi kayong updated sa mga bago kong video. Like and share naman. Pero dapat, don't skip the ads! Lagi tayo mga kamathnik. At ngayon, simulan na natin ang ating aralin. Again, I am going to discuss with you how to read and measure temperature using thermometer. When we say thermometer, ayan, pakitandaan natin ito, it is an instrument that is used to measure temperature. Ano naman ang ibig sabihin ng temperature? The temperature tells us how hot or cold something is. Okay, now, we have different kinds of thermometer. Siguro napapansin nyo, no? We have the most common nowadays, yung binabaril kayo kapag kayo ay papasok sa mga establishment, no? We have digital thermometers. But before, we have this, eto. We call this liquid or alcohol or mercury-filled thermometer. At yan ang ating focus kasi yung digital ay madali lang basahin dahil automatic lang natin makikita yung numbers o yung result ng temperature ng isang tao. Kaya ano ba itong liquid or yung alcohol o yung tinatawag na mercury-filled thermometer? Okay? By the way, eto po yan. Ang ating unit of measure ng temperature ay ang ito po, degrees Celsius at saka yung degrees Fahrenheit. Here in our country, of course, in the Philippines, we use the unit degrees Celsius. Yan po yung ginagamit natin. Kaya pag nanonood kayo ng mga balita, nakikinig kayo sa mga radyo, no, kapag binabanggit yung temperatura ng ating panahon, especially ngayon, no, napakainit ng panahon, ay ginagamit natin yung degrees Celsius. While, ito pong pangalawa, degrees Fahrenheit naman ito. So, ito naman usually, it is commonly used in the United States of America. So, ayan. So, it's either degrees Celsius or degrees Fahrenheit. Pero focus tayo sa ating ginagamit, which is degrees Celsius. Now, we have also different parts of this thermometer. We have the first one, yung nakapalibot doon, yung glass. We call that glass tube, which holds the glass bulb. Ano naman yung glass bulb mamaya? Also, we have yung kulay red. We call that the alcohol or mercury, which is the liquid. Ayan, makikita nyo inside the bulb, which rises when hot At ito naman ay nag-goes down kapag ito ay malamig, when it is cool. Okay? Then we have also the glass bulb, kung saan nakalagay yung ating mercury o yung alcohol, no? Glass bulb, ayan po, yung pinag-lalagyan ng ating liquid, yung tumataas. Then we have also the scale. When we say scale, it tells how far the mercury or the alcohol or the liquid rises and goes down. Ulitin ko, pag tumataas yung ating liquid, ibig sabihin umiinit yung ating temperature. Pag bumababa, yun yung lumalamig ang ating temperature. Okay, now let us try now to read this kind of thermometer. No, the lines on most thermometers are marked every 10 degrees. Ayan. Kung makikita nyo, ayan, 10, 20, 30, 40. Now, the lines in between, pagkikita natin, no? The lines in between are usually counted by twos. Okay? You can check it. Now, here is how we're going to check it. Choose one mark. So, let us choose, for example, 30. Then, let us count by twos. We have 32, 34, 36, 38. Then, the next is 40. So, we can check if the number, when we matches the number on the mark line, then we know that the lines of the thermometer are counted by twos. So, you have to check whether it is by twos or by one. So, it depends on the lines in between. So let us try to read the temperature on this thermometer. We have already checked to make sure the thermometer lines are counted by twos. Nakita nyo kanina, okay? So the red liquid, makikita nyo kung hanggang saan, is past, lumagpas ng 30 degree line but has not reached the 40 degree line. So we start counting at the 30 degree line. So we have to count by twos. So we have 30, then we have 32. Therefore, the temperature on this thermometer is 32 degrees Celsius. Okay, so let's try another one. Again, we have already checked to make sure the thermometer lines are counted by twos. So makikita naman dito, the red liquid, ayan po, is past, lumagpas po ng 40 degree line but has not reached the 50 degree line. So let's start counting at the 40s by 2s, 42, 44, 46, and we have 48. Therefore, the temperature on this thermometer is 48 degrees Celsius. Okay, let's try one more. We have already checked again. The thermometer, it is also by twos. So the red liquid now is past 10 degree but has not reached the 20 degree line. So let us count. 10, 12, 14, 16. Therefore, the temperature on this thermometer is 16 degrees Celsius. So what do we do if we discover the lines are not counted by twos? For example, eto. So, we must figure out what the lines are counted by. So, ano ba ang ating hint yan? Okay. So, we have by fives and paano natin bibilangin yung between dun sa ating by five? Remember, let us start at, okay, for example, we have 10. Yes, the lines on this thermometer are counted by 1. So, we have 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So, ganun lang, no? I-check nyo lang kung ano ba yung ginamit. By 10s ba? Tapos, yung gitna ay by 2s. Or katulad nito, by 5s. Tapos, yung gitna nila ay by 1s na ang pagbilang. So, let's try to read the temperature of this thermometer. So, we have already checked and have found the lines are counted by 1. So, kung makikita nyo ulit dito, the red liquid is past the 20 degree line, pero hindi pa niya naaabot ang 25 degree line. So, anong gagawin natin? We will count 20, 21, 22. Therefore, the temperature on this thermometer is 22 degrees Celsius. Okay, now, as part of our topic, we need to take note of the following. Okay, huwag niyong kakalimutan yung mga standard measurement ng temperature. Let's start with, Ayan, lagi niyong tatandaan that the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. So, yung kumukulo, ibig sabihin yung temperature niyan is 100 degrees Celsius. Now, yung pinaka-yelo o nagyayelong tubig naman has 0 degrees Celsius po. Ha? Yan yung ating freezing point of water. And the normal body temperature natin is 37 degrees Celsius. No? Okay, pag 40, anong ibig sabihin noon? May high fever ka na. Okay, so 37 degrees Celsius is the normal body temperature. So, yan pa lang kung naiisip mo na yan at alam mo na yung mga idea na ito, madali mo nang ma-estimate ang mga temperature ng mga bagay-bagay. For example, ito, i-try natin yan kung kaya-kaya nyong ma-estimate ito. Ano? Okay, so let us estimate the temperature of the following. Okay, so let's start. What do you think is the appropriate temperature of a hot coffee? Yes, it is 80 degrees Celsius kasi malapit siya sa boiling point of water. What about if you are going to have a strawberry shake? What is the appropriate temperature do you think? It's 5 degrees Celsius or 50 degrees Celsius? Of course, malapit siya sa freezing point, which is 5 degrees Celsius. What about, nabanggit ko na, if you have a high fever, sana wag naman, what do you think is the temperature? Yes, it's 40 degrees Celsius, no? Then, kung ikaw naman ay nasa air-conditioned room, what do you think is the temperature? Mas malamig, of course, it's 20 degrees Celsius. Okay? So, that's it. Let us proceed now to solving problems involving temperature. Let's start with problem number one. So, the weather report in one newspaper predicted the lowest temperature for the day to be 24 degrees Celsius and the highest at 32 degrees Celsius. What was the difference in the predicted temperatures for that day? Again, you can follow again the four basic steps in solving the problems. But today, I will just give you the specific, the way how we're going to solve a problem. No, so, in this manner, no, we are looking for the difference in the predicted temperatures for that day. So, the clue word is obviously we are looking for the difference. So, what do you think is the operation kapag hinahanap natin ay difference? Yes, it is subtraction. So, we can now identify the given. We have 24 degrees Celsius and yung highest natin ay 32 degrees Celsius. So, to get now the mathematical equations, we can do 32 degrees Celsius minus 24 degrees Celsius equals n. So, let's subtract. We have 32 minus 24. Obviously, it is 8 degrees Celsius. So, we have now the answer to the problem. The difference in the predicted temperatures for that day is 8 degrees Celsius. Okay? Let's proceed to problem number two. From the normal body temperature, Joseph's temperature rose by 2 5/10 degrees Celsius due to high fever. So what do you think now is Joseph's body temperature? So obviously, no? Let us understand. So hinahanap ngayon yung body temperature ni Joseph. So there's a clue word, from the normal body temperature. So huwag kalimutan ulit, what is the normal body temperature? We have, yes, 37 degrees Celsius. No, another clue word is rose, tumaas. So pag tayo ay tumataas ang number, what we gonna do? Yes, it is addition. So we can now create the mathematical equation. 37 degrees Celsius from the normal body temperature plus yung tumaas ang kanyang temperature na 2 5/10 degrees Celsius. So simply add 37.0 as the decimal. No, we have the whole number 37. Kaya lalagyan lang natin ng 0.0 plus i-add natin yung decimal number na 2.5. So 37.0 plus 2.5. It's obviously again 39.5 or 39 5/10 degrees Celsius. So yun yung kanyang temperature. So, mataas. So, dapat dali na agad si Joseph, no, sa pinakamalapit na clinic or hospital. Kasi nga masyadong mataas. Nakakabahala kapag ganito ang temperature. Mataas na lagnat. Okay? So, ayan ha. Now, we will proceed to problem number 3. The recorded temperatures for 5 days were 24 degrees Celsius, 27 degrees Celsius, 29 and 2/10 degrees Celsius, 29 and 8/10 degrees Celsius, and 30 degrees Celsius. What was the average temperature? Ayan ang ating kinukuha. Average, no? Kapag kinukuha yung average, no? Alam nyo ba kung paano? Kapag kinukuha nyo rin yung average ng grades nyo, di ba? Alam na alam nyo ito. So, we will have two operations here. We have addition and division. So, ano yung i-add natin? So, here is the mathematical equation. We will add the five temperatures. Then, we will divide it by 5. So, let's add first. We have 24 plus 27 plus 29.2, 29.8 plus 30. We'll start adding on the rightmost digits. So, 2 plus 8 magiging 10, carry 1. So, ayan na ang ating sagot. We had 140.0 or 140. We can now divide into how many given? We have 5. So, we will divide it by 5. So, 140, let's start with 14 divided by 5. We have 2 times 5. We have 10. We have a remainder of 4. Then, bring down 0. So, 40 divided by 5, it is 8 because 8 times 5 is 40. So, wala nang remainder. That means the average temperature in 5 days is 28 degrees Celsius. Okay. So, I think we are done with our topic for quarter 4, week number 4. So, ganun lang naman kasimple, no? You just analyze the problems if you are going to use addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. It depends on the clue words na binibigay natin sa mga problems. So, this time, to test if you really learned in our lesson for this week, get ready and say, Math Try Nga! Alright, calling of you grade 5 learners, please type or comment your answers in the comment section of this episode, no? Just type your complete name, the name and location of your school, and of course, your answer. So, this time, I have only 5 items to answer. It's multiple choice, kaya madali lang makuha ang sagot. You can pause the question if you want to read and understand it over and over again. Are you ready? Let's do Math Try Nga! Number 1. What is the temperature on the thermometer? Is it A, 22 degrees Celsius, B, 24 degrees Celsius, C, 26 degrees Celsius, D, 28 degrees Celsius? Number 2. Which of the following given is the normal body temperature? A, 20 degrees Celsius, B, 37 degrees Celsius, C, 40 degrees Celsius, D, 100 degrees Celsius. Number 3, what is 25 degrees Celsius above the boiling point of water? Is it A, 75 degrees Celsius, B, 100 degrees Celsius, C, 125 degrees Celsius, D, 155 degrees Celsius? Number 4, the weather forecast in the television advised that the temperature per today would be 33 degrees Celsius, but it is 4 degrees Celsius hotter than what is said in the forecast. What is the actual temperature? A, 29 degrees Celsius, B, 37 degrees Celsius, C, 38 degrees Celsius, D, 40 degrees Celsius. Number 5, the temperatures on 4 different days were 29 degrees Celsius, 28 degrees Celsius, 27 degrees Celsius, and 30 degrees Celsius. What was the average temperature? Is it A, 27 degrees Celsius, B, 28 degrees Celsius, C, 28 5/10 degrees Celsius, or D, 29 5/10 degrees Celsius? So I think you have now your answer. Kindly comment it now and abangan. Baka kayo ang ating maging Mathinik of the Week sa susunod nating episode. And before we finally end, eto na I would like to present to you yung ating mga napakabibilis sumagot at nakakuha ng ating perfect score sa nakaraang episode natin. Sila yung ating mga Mathenics of the Week! Ang ating kauna-unahan, ang una nakasagot at perfect ay nagmula. Ayan, ang ating Suki, ang ating napaka Hall of Famer na ata ito from Pembo Elementary School. Congratulations, Prince William C. Perez! Ang ating second Mathenic of the Week, ang napakabilis din from Taguig Integrated School, Santa Ana, Taguig City. Walang iba kundi si Rondo Devin G. Onza. Ang ating third na pinakamabilis na nakakuha ng perfect score, nagmula naman sa Maharlika Integrated School, again Taguig City. Congratulations to Andrew Emmanuel D. Vego. Ang ating fourth Mathenic of the Week, syempre, isa pa sa mga suki natin. No? Congratulations sa aking learner from Rizal Elementary School, Vitor C. Arcega. And our fifth Mathenic of the Week ay from Pangil Elementary School, Cavite Province. We have Christine M. Garcia. Alright, again, thank you so much. Congratulations to all of you at sa iba din na nagko-comment na nakukuha din ng perfect score sa ating math trying. Keep up your good attitude. Remember that the best way to learn is to apply what you have learned. And if you get a mistake, do not worry. That is another way of learning. Again, shout out po sa inyong lahat, lahat ng mga sumusuporta at nag-aabang ng aking mga episode. Thank you very much po mga kaguro, mga magulang at mga mag-aaral mula Luzon hanggang sa Mindanao. God bless po! And that concludes our episode for this fourth quarter week number 4. Again, maraming salamat. See you in the next episode. Happy learning!